Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to the Silent Age. We are continuing on with the main, well, campaign, or this, rather, I don't think the campaign would be a good way to phrase this thing. No, we are continuing on with the story. And next up is Chapter 3, The Machine. Having escaped police custody using the time machine, Joe is now on the run and in search of the time traveler. Convinced he has been taken to the local hospital, actually getting there is proving difficult. Local hospital, huh? Interesting. I mean, if you think about all of it, it sort of feels like a plot wherein he's being framed for something, because that same parking attendant knew that the time traveler was going to be there, meaning that somebody had tipped him off, probably from the future, or he himself was from the future, and he actually came there specifically to shoot the time traveler. Now, Joe here got involved. I forgot his last name, but Joe here got involved. And Joe Smith, I think. Yeah. So Joe here got involved in all of this, and he was pretended to be arrested by the police. However, he actually did not get to the police station. He instead took him to a local hospital, from the looks of it. It seems pretty... No, I mean, they did take him to the police station. Convinced he has been taken to the local hospital. I suppose he's talking about that guy, whatever his name is. The time traveler. So, apparently the time traveler has been taken to the local hospital. I don't remember whether he actually said that in the first video or not, the first chapter of the present. Anyhow, it seems like there's something fishy going on here, at least with the parking attendant, because who in the right mind is going to shoot a random old man for not parking in the right spot? Anyhow, let's get this. As always, a nice touch. Okay, now I know this isn't just some horrible nightmare. I need to breathe and get a grip. So that's the rope we came down from. If all of this is really happening, someone must have taken that time travel guy to the hospital or something. I need to get over there. I'm not sure what I'll get out of it, but I have nothing else to go on. There's a motorcycle here that I can hardly see. Yeah, I can see it better now. I think the sun's in my eyes, which is causing problems for me. That seems to be the holding cell, hospital in the horizon. Barred windows. I'll be seeing a lot more of that if I don't get far away from you soon. And there's a motorcycle here, which of course we probably cannot use. Poison ivy. This motorcycle is nothing but busted up junk now. Hospital in the horizon. I can see the hospital. I bet the time travelers brought there after they arrested me. I doubt that. Poison ivy is something that I would like to... If there's any chance I might find some answers, this would be the place to start. Now, as the name suggests, poison ivy is something that you want to be stay away from. Oh, there's sunlight here. I wonder why this particular spot. Jeez, that thing almost scared me after that. The device is lit up now. The light must have recharged it, so I guess it's working again. Now, I would not want to use this until the very end. Of course, it's locked. But given how things are, I think we might just need to. Man. It's completely rusted up. And of course, I would like to stay away from poison ivy. Touching it is not going to help at all. So, what we can do instead is pretty much just use this thing here to go back in time, since nothing else works. So I'm pretty sure the motorcycle would work at that point in time. As it does. There's a back door into the police station, and there's like a fire escape ladder that we can use to probably... Fire escape ladder is too high up to reach, even if I jump. The back door is probably still shut. I'd find some other way. Motorcycle tool bag. I see. There's a screwdriver in here. That could come in handy. Back locked door. It's locked. Lucky, it was a slam lock. You know how to pick locks, don't you? You know a lot about picking locks. There's an umbrella here that we can use. A little battered, but otherwise in fine shape. I wonder what use the umbrella would give me. Maybe to pull down the fire escape hatch there. I thought we were going to use the motorcycle for a grand getaway, but apparently yes. Not. Got it. Okay, fire escape ladder. Back into the police station then. There's a ladder, there's apartment 1G, there's an apartment 1F. It's locked, of course it is. I don't exactly want to ring any of the doorbells, but... I mean, this is one of the games that I really like because of how sensible everything is in this game. Nice thick rug. Great looking pants. Might as well use this. Whoever lives here has great taste in threads. Except they left it all getting wet in the rain. Maybe we can try the doorbells? I don't know if that's gonna work. I wonder how there are no stairs on any of these sides. Because, well... I guess nobody's home, of course. Didn't think it would actually help, but tried it nonetheless. Now, I wonder what the rug is gonna be used for, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be of use sometime later. I think, after we get out of here, we're probably gonna have to go back to the future. Going inside the police station is pointless. Garage door. I think it's the station garage. I should really get out of here fast. A car could be coming out any minute. Police car. Should we use this? The door is locked. I don't think I want to go back into the police station, actually. Should we? I mean, I guess this door here would still be open. Yes, it is. So, if required... Yeah, we are in the sunlight. It is fully charged, so... Wait a minute. There could be something else up there now. Since we brought the... stairs down, there would probably be something up there. Oh, the stairs are gone altogether. No worries then. But at least the car would probably still work. And yeah, this puzzles in this point-and-click game are very sensible. Is the reason that I really like this game. Open car door. There's something in there. I found a nightstick. I just threw up a little. I didn't exactly expect to find another corpse in here. And I wonder why I don't get in cars with dead people. It's a policy that's served me well so far. Okay, let's use the carpet with the window. I can't use the carpet here. Nightstick, huh? I've seen Dirty Harry, so has every cop in this town. I really don't need to know what happens to me if I start banging up this patrol car. Yeah, didn't think that would be the appropriate course of action either. But had to try it nonetheless. Yeah. So, I'm sort of stuck here at this point. I don't know how to proceed further. But, there are so many places I really don't need to be right now. Parking garage full of angry armed police officers is high on that list. let's enter the police station then. I know I've had many great ones lately, but this is a really stupid idea. They're probably already looking for me. It's hot as much, actually. Maybe go back into the future? I don't know. Whole street is that quiet. It creeps me out. I can't use the carpet here. Don't think this is gonna help any. There's not much I can do to this car that hasn't already happened. Windows. Probably climb in through here, I suppose. No signs of life. Use carpet with windows. Let's try that again. I don't think it registered properly. I could use the carpet to protect myself from the broken glass, but I have no reason to go in there again.
Exactly.
So what are we doing here, is the question. So there's one more place that I haven't checked yet. Wait a minute. So I was saying there's one more place that I haven't checked yet, but... there's some poison ivy. The garage door opens automatically, but even if there was power, it only opens from the inside. So basically we need to get inside the police department here, so maybe we should... yeah. Barred windows. Beautiful. I always wanted to learn how to ride. I'd grow my mustache and bones, get a leather jacket and just live on the road. The back door. It won't budge. Okay, maybe we can go upstairs. And yeah, now let's try this. So there's poison ivy growing on that side. It's locked. Maybe this might help things. If it was that easy, I'm pretty sure there would be more break-ins, as am I. Okay, back up we go, and maybe there's something here, who knows? You never know. Oh yeah, there is a bar down. Great looking pants. It's still there. Polyester. Can't beat it. Unsettling. I mean, door to apartment 1G plastered over the window. I wonder what you can see from the outside. Not much of a view, just more apartment buildings. It's a wonder they get light in here at all. Oh, that's some lazy renovation.
Crud.
The handle's missing. Key seems to have been broken off in the lock. Okay. Darkness. That's all there is. It's too dark to see anything. Let's go ahead and open the window open. And this like wallpaper paste right here. Whoever was decorating the walls, they sure left in a hurry recently too. The paste is still sticky. Wallpaper. Might be a strange comment at this point, but I'm gonna go ahead and say it anyway. I'm totally digging that wallpaper. Glad you like it. There's also a lamp here. I don't know why. There's something in there. Oh hey, there's a key. Someone hit a key in the lampshade. I wonder what it's for. Probably that apartment building there. Because I'm quite certain it's not gonna work with this door here. Well, it did. Yeah. So we're probably gonna have to access it through this side here. Can't exactly... let's try going back in the future. So this is the dynamic that I really like in this game. The wallpaper is missing, I know that, but wallpaper paste... I'm not sure that'll work, neither am I sure about that. Yeah. I wonder why there's like a carpet there. Poison ivy? Maybe I could whack the bush. Beat it to death with a stick? Just look at this monster. It would probably be faster yelling it to death at this point. Maybe if I could get at it before it grew this big. Ah, I see. Come on, move it. I haven't got all day. Alright, time to break this then. So that was the correct course of action. It would just grow back. I need to ruin the soil. Of course. Done. It's seeping into the soil. Extreme garden. Now when we head into the future, there will be no poison ivy here. I love this game.
Man.
The handle broke off. How does stuff like this keep happening? Well, I suppose we can use this handle to get in through the other door. The one that joins this side of the apartment. Now, what? The question that I have is, how is the fire exit, the emergency fire exit, the only way to get up to these apartments? Why isn't there like a... oh yeah, I mean, there is a back door. I'm assuming there must be a front door as well, one that we can't see. But the question is, why would there be calling bells on, like, the fire exit site. That doesn't make sense at all to me. There's a tree blocking that window, and there's like a lot of garbage here. Pretty sure nothing here of value. Let's go back to the present, and it's on. Looks like a special news bulletin. Chill for a moment. That's the achievement I got. Ovun government denies any serious threat and assures us that the fatal incidents we've been reporting all morning are completely neutral and unrelated. I see. So it's like just we managed to... We basically, the present is right before an extinction level event is what it seems like. Nothing in here. The window though. Might be something there. This back alley, I should be able to slip into it. It's not too far down either. Unfortunately, this is another one of those windows that don't open. I mean, that's not really an issue. We can, like, just... It's unlocked now. I get that, but why would I want to unlock it, is the question. There's nobody at home. Let's break it open with this. I hope nobody heard that. This carpet should do the trick. When we come back, we will be covering Chapter 4, The Entry. As for this video, Chapter 3, The Machine. This was it. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end, despite me not having all the answers right off the bat, and more or less just figuring things out. And that's one of the things I like about this game, is how the solutions are all intuitive. It's not like, you know, what's the name of that game, that LucasArts game? I forgot the name. It's about this pirate, and the solutions to the puzzles in that are downright cartoonish. And it might have been humorous, but it makes figuring out the solutions to puzzles just that much more difficult, and it becomes like more of like, you know, just a game of combinatrix. If you see something that you can click on, just click on it with everything that you can find, and that's... It doesn't make sense to me, is all. But anyway, once we come back, we will be covering Chapter 4, The Entry. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.